If you or a loved one are suffering from genital warts, or you think you're suffering from genital warts, then look no further. In this video, I'll talk about genital warts, what causes genital warts, what they look like, how to treat them, and talk about conditions that look like genital warts, but are not genital warts. Could be a great relief for anyone watching that you may actually not have genital warts. So let's talk about genital warts briefly. Genital warts are caused by viruses belonging to the human papillomavirus family. That is a very versatile family of viruses. They can cause warts and other types of lesions from head to toe, including genital warts, warts on the hands, warts inside the mouth, warts anywhere and everywhere on the body. That being said, viruses that cause genital warts usually are pretty partial to the privates, the perianal area, and inside the mouth, where they can actually cause cancer of the inside of the mouth, the oropharynx, and the anal area. These are pretty rare, but that can still happen, and those cancers can be associated with human papillomaviruses that can cause genital warts. Now, these viruses are transmitted through skin-to-skin or skin-to-mucosa contact, so they usually are transmitted by skin cells or mucosal cells that are packed with viruses that land on healthy skin or healthy mucosa. Those cells break apart and the viruses infect healthy cells in the vicinity of where the cells attach themselves. So the infection process is actually pretty straightforward. However, interestingly enough, the time frame from getting infected to developing warts is variable. It can take anywhere from a few days to years or even decades. So I always mention that to patients who come in who have genital warts or whose partners have genital warts. Genital warts are not necessarily proof of an affair or illicit sex, as that person suffering from genital warts may have acquired the virus years or even decades before the warts broke out or the cancer broke out. For more information about genital warts and other genital conditions, pick up my book, Sick Skin, Skincare Made Simple, today at Amazon Books at the link below right there. Now let's get on with the video. So warts are bumps that are usually verrucous, meaning they're rough to the touch, sort of gritty to the touch. They can be skin colored, they can be gray, they can be brown, they can even be pink or black. And they usually appear in crops over the privates. In men, they usually affect the shaft of the penis and the scrotum area. Obviously, the perianal area as well can be affected. And in women, they usually affect the labia majora, meaning the big lips of the vulva. So those are areas that are usually affected with genital warts. That being said, warts can affect any area of the anal genital area. It's just that those parts that I mentioned are more prone to getting warts on them for whatever reason. It's probably the virus has a bigger affinity for those areas and has an easier time developing the warts over the areas that I mentioned. Now, diagnosing the warts is pretty straightforward most of the time. I will go over some conditions that can look like warts, especially to the undiscerning eye, and must be distinguished from warts because the approach and the treatment can be very different. Now, as far as treating warts, treatment is pretty versatile, but the most effective ways of getting rid of warts is destroying them locally, specifically with liquid nitrogen, electrocautery, and sometimes with blistering agents such as cantharidine, which is a derivative of a blistering beetle, which is very interesting. There are other types of treatment like chemotherapeutic creams, specifically imiquimod or 5-fluorouracil. There are other compounds as well. There's treatment with topical podophyllin. And then there are various anti-cancer medications that can be injected into warts like bleomycin and 5-fluorouracil, which I mentioned earlier as a cream application to warts. Another way of treating warts is by immunosensitization, specifically using antigens like candin or the MMR vaccine injected into warts and theoretically sensitizing the immune system to the warts, because mind you, the warts that are on the skin may be visible to you, but the immune system is not recognizing those warts as a foreign entity. That's why they get to stick around and not be quashed by the immune system. Those sensitization methods supposedly turn the immune system on the warts and have the immune system destroy the warts. So there's a very wide range of treatments for the warts. As I've mentioned, the destructive methods are the most effective. They're not very pleasant, but they are the most effective. Now, warts can take anywhere from a few weeks to a few months and sometimes even years to treat and make go away, depending on the numbers of warts, on the immune status of the individual, and other factors, probably genetic and environmental, that lead to the rate of response to treatment to warts. But they must be treated for them to disappear. They usually do not go away by themselves. And the individual carrying those warts is more infectious, supposedly, because they have greater numbers of human papillomavirus on the skin. Now, interestingly enough, as I've mentioned, it's very hard to track the time from acquiring the human papillomavirus, which is invisible, obviously, it's a microscopic, ultra-microscopic particle, to developing the warts. Interestingly enough, and it is believed by many people in the human papilloma world, that human papillomavirus actually resides naturally on the skin in many individuals and cannot be really diagnosed or discerned until it causes warts or causes other signs of human papillomavirus disease. If you enjoyed this video, please share, like, and subscribe. Put a comment in the comment section. Share from your experience in the world out there. What are your thoughts about human papillomavirus? How big of a problem is it? How difficult it is to get rid of? And if you have any questions, please post them in the comment section. I will do my best to answer those questions. Now let's get on with the video. Having genital warts is a very, very distressing situation to be in, but some people coming into the clinic may be pleasantly surprised. There are lesions that are not warts and in fact are not infectious that can appear very similar to warts on the privates and can be distinguished by the expert eye and by additional testing sometimes to be different from warts and thus treated very differently. One of those conditions is called seborrheic keratosis. Seborrheic keratoses are bumps that look very similar to warts and in many cases are almost impossible to distinguish from warts visually, in which case we do tend to get a biopsy of these lesions and distinguish them under the microscope. So microscopically, there are very subtle differences that can tell the pathologist, the person who examines the specimen under the microscope, whether or not they're dealing with genital warts or they're dealing with another condition such as seborrheic dermatitis. Another condition that can confuse people with warts is sebaceous hyperplasia of the privates. Sebaceous hyperplasia, which are skin-colored, yellow-colored, sometimes they're pink-colored, 1 millimeter bumps on the shaft of the penis, sometimes on the labia majora, can be very similar looking to warts, especially if you're not that experienced in looking at warts and diagnosing them. And that can scare the bejesus out of anybody who has them, especially if they just appear out of the blue. That can be very scary to the individual. However, those lesions are completely benign. They're not infectious. And most of the time, we just leave them alone unless they bother the individual and they want to get rid of them for aesthetic reasons. Another entity that can be pretty scary to anyone are what we call pearly penile papules. Those are verrucous, meaning they're a little rough, and they appear usually around the head of the penis, and they can look very similar to warts. They can be easily distinguished from warts because the pattern or the configuration of how they appear looks very distinct and very different from warts, which are kind of thrown all over the place. Pearly penile papules appear almost as a crown around the head of the penis, and that is very different from having genital warts. But obviously, you need an expert eye to tell you that. And many people suffering from those come into the clinic thinking that they have genital warts. Another condition which can be confused with genital warts, but is certainly not genital warts, are syringomas. Syringomas are a type of benign tumors. They're about 1 millimeter in size. They're skin colored to sometimes a little bit translucent colored, and they can appear on the shaft of the penis and on the labia majora as well. So they can also come as multiple lesions erupting over the areas that I just described. And that can be very scary to the individual thinking they might have developed genital warts, especially when there's a history of sexual encounters or multiple sexual, especially when there's a history of sexual encounters, those individuals might be very scared about having genital warts. Luckily enough, they can show up to see a dermatologist and have their condition clarified like that. If you enjoyed this video, share, like, and subscribe. Put a comment in the comment section. I'll do my best to answer those questions. Now to summarize the video, genital warts are caused by human papillomaviruses. Those viruses can actually lead to genital warts as well as perianal warts, as well as lesions inside the oropharynx. They can rarely lead to cancer, and warts generally need to be treated to go away. They do not go away on their own. The most effective treatment methods are destruction of the warts through liquid nitrogen, electrocautery, and other methods. And again, they must be disappeared. The fact that you have warts is not proof necessarily of an affair, as the time frame from getting the virus, contracting it, to developing the lesions is variable, meaning it can be days, it could be weeks, it could be months, sometimes years, or even decades from the time you acquire the virus to developing those lesions, such as warts or, God forbid, cancer. Now, as far as other lesions on the privates, there are several groups of other types of lesions that can look like warts, especially to the undiscerning eye. Well, that sums it up for this video. Share, like, and subscribe. Put some comments in the comment section. I'll do my best to answer any questions you have regarding this topic and other skin issues. More great content coming your way right from this channel. Thanks for watching, and God bless.